Hey guys, today we're going to show you how to perform the button mapping on the Claw Shoot mobile controller. So we begin by switching the gamepad on in the button mapping mode. Simply press A and home. That will bring up LED 1. Since I've already connected the gamepad to the phone, my LED 1 is switched on and constantly on. After connecting, we have to open the Shooting Plus V3 app, which you can download from the App Store. As you can see, it shows here that the gamepad is connected. These are the available games which have the predefined profiles on the app. So maybe if you're playing PUBG, we simply click on PUBG and you can download the profile to any of the four profiles available. So for example, we're going to use download to home plus up. That's downloading the preset keys available on the app. Once that's done, you need to minimize the V3 app and we can launch the game. Once you start the game, you'll need to go into the control settings. As you can see, I'm already on the control setting page. And to configure the buttons, you need to press the start button on the gamepad. This will bring up all the available options. This is the preset that we downloaded. So as you can see, most of the buttons are already configured. You can still customize by clicking on any of the buttons and moving them to your desired location. So you can modify the existing preset, or if you'd like to make a new profile, you simply need to click on new at the top. This will bring up a blank screen. To get this profile customized, you need to now click the button on the gamepad and that will bring it up on the screen. So for example, you can see I've pressed A and you can drag and drop that to any part of the screen that you like. So for example, I would like A to be jump, so I put it up there on the jump. I get my left analog stick, put it there. I get my right analog stick. On the right analog stick, when you drag and drop it there, you need to click on it. By default, it's on ordinary stick, but we'd want that to be the view. So we'll select view, and I recommend keeping the speed setting to 2 so that it's fairly sensitive while gaming. This is a very important thing that you need to do while creating a new profile only. Following the other buttons, let's get the shoot, which I keep as L2. So we drag and drop that there. I usually use zoom as R2 or RT, so we put in the zoom there. To select your guns, you can use the left digital stick and the right digital stick. And as you can see, you keep pressing the button on the gamepad, which will pop up in the middle of the screen, and you can drag and drop it to your desired location. This can be done for all the buttons that you like. So this is the way that you can go ahead and configure each and every button. Once you're done with that, you simply have to click save. This will ask you whether you want to save your profile to the device. You simply keep the first box ticked and click OK. After doing this, you can see that your preset has been saved and you're ready to game. If you ever want to come and modify it again, you simply just press the start button and you can move things around as you please. While you're in the game, if you want to view the buttons that you set up and you want to keep it up on the screen, all you simply need to do is press the back button. This will open up to show you the buttons that you've configured as a display. It will not allow you to move it. It is only for visual. So this is the way you can go ahead and configure your buttons. And if you need any support, feel free to get in touch with our customer care team. We are more than happy to help you. And wish you a happy gaming.